Welcome back to Hermitcraft. All right. Well, I'll tell you what. Here we are. Season 5 server. Pretty much the central area / community area, so on. And you can see here there's some temporary structures up, and things are slowly getting started. You know how it is. Day 1 in a new world. It's all those basic beginner Minecraft things you gotta do. And I think what I'm going to do is I've put together a few things here, cut some wood after I finally got here, and I have a little bit of iron left from what I mined while I was on the way, and so on. And I'm gonna head out this way and kinda do like several others have. I'm gonna head out to the area where I'm gonna do my main build thing, and I'm going to get something of a starter home put together there, probably a very temporary thing, because you know how it is when you're first getting started. You just need a place to be inside where you don't have to worry about mobs, and you have a bed in there and some chests with your stuff in it, and so on. So I am going to head out this way and get over to this thing. There's going to be an ocean boat ride involved, because it's kind of a ways. Not hideously far, but a decent little ways. But it's the perfect area for the build that I want to try to do this season. And this is going to be one of those builds that, you know how it is when you get a big build going and you're tweaking it and perfecting it and working on it for the whole freaking season. That's the kind of thing that I'm aiming for here, and hopefully I can pull it off without making it look bad. Because one of the things is my goal for season 5 is to build something that looks good enough that people will look at it and say, hey, that looks cool. So, yeah. I got a big job ahead of me. I know that. So, I'm going to head this way, and I will catch you when I get there. All right. I think I'm just about here. Okay, now, if I get out here, just leave the boat. Should be a little bit of water here. And then if I go ahead and cross this, yeah, this is it. Nice, good-sized little forest area. Well, not quite little. As a matter of fact, I'll show you a picture here of the map that shows this place. And this is the area where I'm going to do the build that I have in mind. And basically, what I'm looking at is a fairly large fort-type area built in this forest. And, a good-sized walled fort, the kind of thing that might even qualify as a sort of kind of almost fortress. And it's big. This is a big enough idea that it's going to take me all season, practically, to work on this thing. But I'm good with that, because this is going to be cool. So I think what I'm going to start out with, I think it's time to start cutting some wood. Get myself some wood together here, and the first thing I want is a basic shack. In a decent location, because then over time I want to upgrade the shack into a cabin. And that cabin will end up being probably some kind of a centerpiece-ish kind of part of the overall build. The whole fort, it's going to be a walled fort, so it'll be walled all the way around. And, I think it's going to be good. but it's going to take a lot of time to get it all built up right. But I want a decent, I want a kind of a cool, scenic looking place to start. And I think maybe right here on the edge of this lake or lake type thing might just be the ticket. Fortunately, the commute back to the central spawn area isn't a very big one. It's actually fairly quick. The only thing that took me a long time was that I left as it was getting towards late in the day. It got dark, so I stayed out on the water a few hundred blocks away from this place, hoping that I was far enough away to not have it load up and start spawning hostiles. And then in the morning, just a few minutes ago, I just kind of paddled the rest of the way in. And now we can get started on something like a cabin. Well, initially just a shack, I know, yeah. Maybe not even very pretty, but temporary at first. Right now, I just need a place to have a roof over my head, some walls to keep the mobs out, and a place for some storage, and so on. Why aren't you despawning? Come on, hurry up. I got stuff to build, and I don't need you here. And yes, I know I'm wearing out my axe. What the heck? It's stone. It's cheap. All right. Let's get started with something here. And I'm even going to start with some logs of the dark oak variety. Just simply because they don't grow right around these parts. Alright, let's throw something down there. Let's come over 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's count it right. I need this tree out of the way. Okay. This cut. Oh, I do have another one, and it's almost shot too. Okay. Like I said, I know I'm going to need to do a bunch of work on this place, but it's enough for a start. Let's get this broken. Because the next thing I want is walls. It's already getting late in the day. There's the west over that way, and there's the sun setting, so. Alright. Let's throw this down about there-ish. Let's start getting some walls up. Zero fancy involved right here, just yet. Fancy will come later. door. Oh, that's right. They come in threes now. Oh, I'll never get used to that. All right. That's a start. Now, speaking of this out here. Yeah, I know. Cobblestone's ugly. Oh well. Don't care. All right. All right, that's a start. I'm going to have to cut a bunch more wood just to even fill this out. And then a whole lot more wood before I head down into a branch mine, which you know that's going to happen. And yes, I'm building a 9x9. Think of it this way. I could have built a 9x9 out of cobblestone. And that right there is one of the reasons. One torch on each wall lights the place up good. I'm going to spend a few more torches lighting up at least some of the immediate surrounding area. And then I'm going to get inside and set a spawn, because I do have a bed with me. All right. And the old rule, don't put your bed right up against the outside wall. There we go. Okay. There we go. First night, new place. Don't have a roof yet. Don't need one that much. Although it would probably be a good idea to throw a few torches up here. Make sure there's no rooftop spawns. There. It's very bare bones. There isn't much to it at all, but it's the beginnings of something. Okay. Oh, please. Come on. I hope I'm not going to be aiming that bad throughout this season. Who am I kidding? I know damn well I'm going to be. I know very well I'm going to be aiming that bad. All right, I've got some mushrooms. I'm going to hang on to those. Maybe I can get some mushrooms growing. I also have some taters and carrots. I need to get those planted. Still have another one of these. Give me those, and I got some cobble. Yon tilling device, and I have exactly enough iron for a bucket. How about that? Let's see, this is not the kind of thing that's going to have lily pads on it, but that's all right. Get some more trees amputated. And get initial garden going. I should be able to get a couple of rows each of potatoes and carrots started. And then there looks like something cave-like over there that is worth checking out and lighting up. All right. I'll end up moving those. And that. Okay, let's just... All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, not the greatest placement. All right. All right, well, how about just right across the house here? One, two, three, four, five, right here. Water. And that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Whatever. That should just about last long enough to finish this place out. Perfect. All right, let's start planting some things here. Start with the carrots, alternate with carrots and potatoes. Hey, how about that? I had enough to plant pretty much the whole place. Very good. All right, that'll get that started. Let's torch up around here. I'm going to need to pick up a little bit of this. Yeah, I'll just grab this. All right, bare bones, basic, but it works. All right, now let's have a look over here, see what we've got locally. I figure if I'm going to be living here, I need to light some of this up. Because I really dislike having noisy neighbors. Hey, iron. All right. And yeah, for anybody who didn't catch it, I am still kind of mentally facepalming about the fact that on the way out to this central area in episode 1, I did a really dumb thing. I tried to mine iron with a wooden pick. That's really, really bad. Hey, coal. All right. And more iron. Well, won't be lacking for iron. Or coal. Joel, it seems. Oh, goody. We have Ravine. And we have Zombie. Come on, move away from him. Remember the new combat mechanic. Now get out of here before you get killed. And have a potato. And yes, caving has never been a favorite pastime of mine. It's a thing that I do when I have to. Like now, it is necessary to go caving. Just to get the area around my home lit up so that we don't have a whole lot of noisy neighbors, unpleasant surprises in the night, and so on. And, of course, to pick up some iron. And some coal. Well, wait a minute. Yeah, that floor's got a little something to it. I'm gonna need this stuff. Alright, I'm gonna need that XP, too. Alright, you know, I just had a kind of a thing happen that you don't ever want to have happen when you're recording video. I stopped the recording and I got notified that there wasn't enough space on my hard drive to save the file. Oh, that was awful. I ended up getting a partial file, which is why what you saw just now got clipped off. Yeah, not my favorite kind of time. Well, I was able to delete a bunch of stuff. I had gotten lazy about deleting stuff that I didn't need anymore. That beats the nothing I had before. There's some glass cooking up, because I am going to want glass in these walls so I can see out. Maybe a glass ceiling, or a ceiling with glass skylights or something like that, just so that there's more light in the daytime and so on and so forth. Alright, put that up. I've got a bunch of stuff here. Okay, pop quiz time. This is very, very, very uber early game on a new world. Who knows what I'm going to do next? And if you said, dig a branch mine, you win the prize. What the prize is, I haven't got a faint idea in the world, but that's the idea. And it's time to dig. Well, maybe I should make a few more torches first. Let's see. That should get me down there and started. And if it goes true to form, I should have at least some reasonable amount of iron and coal by the time I get down to where I plan to start. In any event, this part is not very interesting to watch, so I'll catch you in a bit. Alright, just back up here to get some stuff processed. I got some more iron, picked up some gold too, and a bunch of coal. And I want to do something about getting some first windows in this thing. Just simply because being able to see what's going on around me is always a good thing. Alright. I'll have to be digging up some more sand out of there to get some more of this glass, but this, I can do two more back here. All right, not bad. All right, set that in here. And I've got my branch mine covered over so I won't walk into it and fall off and kill myself to death. That should do for a while. Get one more shovel. And I'm going to take that down with me anyway. All right. Now, there is one more bit of business I feel obligated to finish up before I end the first actual episode, episode 2, whatever. And I'm going to get after that right now. All right, now this is what I call a good sign. I'm not even down at the bottom of my mine shaft yet. I'm still on Y9. I still got a ways to go to get to where I stop digging. And looky what I find. Oh, sweet, there's at least two. How about four? I normally don't mine out around diamonds quite so much, but this is the first diamonds of the season. All right. Yeah, I didn't think there'd be any more down below it. All right. Okay, it's official. Diamonds. Yeah. Yeah. There we go. Now, mind you, I don't necessarily plan on trying to mine, like, crazy amounts of 4,000-some-odd diamonds like I did in Season 4. That was a special case. Although, I expect I will always have as many as I need. Oh yeah. First diamond pickaxe is right there. And yes, I chased the redstone even though I'm not going to use it. Because even if I don't need it, somebody else likely will. In any event, I have arrived at the as deep as I'm going to go point. Now, I was going to dig the corridor out and start doing some actual branches, but hey, I got my diamonds. That's good enough. Yeah, that'll work. I'll need to get some more glass. I like having the levels here. Instead of just filling that in with cobblestone ceilings, I like using glass for that. Just a tradition. It probably doesn't mean very much, but hey, diamonds. Alright, I couldn't let this episode end without coming up with some diamond, and hey, I didn't even have to dig a single branch yet. Just the initial shaft going straight down. That is what I call a good sign. Yeah. Alright. I expect to be making this place look better. And bigger, by the way. This is just the initial shack. I actually do want this to resemble some kind of a cabin. Perhaps a fishing cabin. You know, we're on a lake, so why not, you know? Not necessarily meaning that I'm going to fish out of here. Although, an AFK fish farm is not out of the question. As a matter of fact, it sounds like a bloody great idea. Alright, let's get this done. It's time. For the first diamond pickaxe. Now, in truth, I'll probably use up the iron picks. I do not, however, subscribe to the theory of I'm going to use all this other and not use the diamond for anything. Are you kidding me? I'm going to use the daylights out of that diamond. Because it's going to get me a whole lot more. In any event, before I run out of hard drive space again, I need to put this one to bed and get some editing done and rendering and so on so that I can delete source files. So, thanks for watching. Take it easy. I am out of here.